What is up, YouTube? It's RS Mario here bringing you another video. This time, we are not talking about Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. We are talking about the fact that Nintendo just decided to bless your boy with the greatest birthday gift they possibly could. A Nintendo Direct announcement. And yes, that's exactly what we got. This is not an alarm. This is not a drill. Alright, this is not a false alarm. This is not a false flag mission. This is not a fake leak. All right, this ain't fake leak theater. This is real, okay? So this morning they dropped a tweet. It said, tune in at 7 a.m. Pacific time. You know, rest in peace to you West Coast people. For a Nintendo Direct live stream featuring roughly 40 minutes of information mostly focused on Nintendo Switch games launching this winter. We all know that launching this winter thing is kind of a lie. They always sneak in some stuff that's not launching in that window. They always sneak in some other stuff. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? Want to watch Nintendo Direct? I will be streaming it right here on the channel. Alright, so I will be streaming it right here live on the channel. You're going to see the notification probably pop up tonight. So, of course, if you want to continue getting videos like this from me, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell button. Do all that stuff that YouTube requires you to do. Continue getting videos from me. Like this video. Follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/rsmario128. As well as drop a comment down below to help the channel grow and tell me what you think is going to be at the Nintendo Direct. Alright, so, was not prepared for this video. Was not going to do a video today because it is my birthday. You know what I'm saying? It's my birthday. My birth date. but Nintendo was like, no, bruh. You know, every time I have plans for something, either it's a different type of video or it's something different in my life. Nintendo's like, no, bruh, come on over here. Time for you to make a video. So what could we see at the Nintendo Direct? To be honest, 40 minutes is a long time. You know what I'm saying? So I definitely think that they're going to have some indie stuff there. I definitely think we're going to get to see... One of the big things we're going to get to see is a new Fire Emblem game. So they've already... We already know that there's a Fire Emblem game that is practically done and just queued up in the pipe, ready to go. I've already done a couple videos on it. I already did a video saying that there was 3 Fire Emblem projects in production. One of those was Fire Emblem 3 Hopes. So 3 Hopes is already out. There's one that's already done that's just waiting to go. And the other one in production is probably a remake of either the Tullius games, which are the GameCube Fire Emblem games, or the Draw games? I think they're the Drick Draw games, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, you know, so it could be one of those 2 remakes, but definitely we'll be getting a new Fire Emblem game. More than likely the one that got leaked, because that's already done. Now, could we get a tease at something more? That's possible. You know, it's super hot up in this gym. So if you see me, you know, wiping sweat off, it's because, yeah, we got no... So, what else could we be getting here? So I think we could get a tease at a Mario game. Seeing as though, I mean, Mario, more than likely the next mainline Mario game, be it Mario Odyssey 2, be it something completely different, will probably come out in conjunction with the Mario movie next year. But that doesn't mean that we won't get a hint or a teaser or something like that for the next Mario game. I mean, you know, now of course that could also be for the next Nintendo Direct, which is usually around second quarter 2023 will be the next Nintendo Direct after this. That'll be like February, March, somewhere around that time period. But more than likely, we could get a teaser for the next Mario game. The other thing is some shadow drops, like Advance Wars. If we don't get more, it's pretty much guaranteed to get information about Advance Wars as far as the release goes, and possibly even a shadow drop. I would not be surprised if that didn't just get shadow drop that day. The other thing that we could probably get is some information on Nintendo Online. So I don't know if they're gonna show us like a whole rework of Nintendo Online, because I do think that that's something that's in the cards. But that'll probably be for like when they're ready to talk new hardware or something like that. But I definitely think that they're going to go ahead and announce that eventual update to the expansion pack that will bring in Game Boy and Game Boy Advance games. Like, it's the worst kept secret in Nintendo right now. We already know that it's a thing. Everybody's seen it. Some people have played it. You know what I'm saying? We all know it's a thing. So I wouldn't be surprised if they want to drop that. That will probably be the only Pokemon-like thing that we get as far as news, you know. Because it might have Pokemon trading card game in there. Maybe one of the older Pokemon games will be included. That would be about it, though. I doubt that we get anything else Pokemon related. Unfortunately, you know what I'm saying? Because I would love another trailer. You know me. I eat up at Pokemon information. But we just got a trailer, so more than likely we probably won't get another one for a little while. As far as Metroid goes, since they're talking about games are going to release this winter, I would not be surprised if we don't get any something about possibly the Metroid Prime remake or remaster, however they're going to do it. I think it's going to be a full-blown remake, like just brand new textures, brand new assets completely, like Resident Evil 2 style. You know what I'm saying? Not like a remaster where they take the old assets and they upgrade them. Like, I'm talking about brand new assets all around. I can see them doing that. I made a video about that as well. Most of the stuff I've already talked about. But, I mean, it's stuff that has been kind of in the works and got gummed up because of the pandemic. So, you know, it is what it is. But we could be seeing that as well. Now, of course, the last big thing that we need to see at this direct is Zelda Breath of the Wild. We need something from this game. We have seen less than 4 minutes of this game in 3 years. Okay. Alright, they need to drop something about Breath of the Wild too. Okay. I doubt they're gonna drop the name, because there was one rumor that I was chasing around, maybe to make a video about, that they were gonna drop the name this month. I can't really confirm or deny that, because it's not from reliable sources. So I didn't really run with it. You know, I might have did a fake leak theater or something with it. But, you know, but that's a possibility. I mean, especially since Nintendo's not going to be at the Game Awards. They don't really do Game Awards anymore as far as dropping information there. This is where we're going to get the most stuff. As far as third-party stuff, Genshin Impact. I'm going to keep beating this horse, alright, because it's weird that this is probably one of the only free-to-play massive games that is not on the Switch. I mean, because Apex is on the Switch, Fortnite's on the Switch. There are a ton of these free-to-play games that are big on the Switch, except for Genshin Impact. And I don't know if that's because of the whole Zelda controversy from years ago. Because I remember when Genshin first came out, it was this big controversy because it looked like Breath of the Wild. And people in Japan was like breaking PS4s because the game looked like Breath of the Wild. And people was like, oh, these people just copied Zelda. So maybe that's it. But I don't really see any other reason why Genshin is not on the Switch. Like, I think it's kind of crazy. Especially, and another thing, speaking of crazy, since, Riot Games is feeling froggy, and they've already announced that the game is coming to Game Pass, we could be seeing League and Valorant hop over the Switch. Because it's nothing but money. It's honestly nothing but money for Riot to put one of the biggest multiplayer games around in League on the Switch. I mean, you know what I'm saying? Shoot, there's already a League of Legends clone on the Switch and Pokemon Unite. Why not go ahead and just put regular League on Switch? I mean, I would love to try League. I mean, I'm gonna try it one day, because I'm working on to when I start streaming again, I'm gonna do Pokemon Trainer Tries X game. Like, I'm gonna try Apex, I'm gonna try League, I'm gonna try Valorant, I'm gonna try all the big multiplayer games, you know, especially until Overwatch 2 comes out. Then, you know, I'm not gonna be all about Overwatch 2. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's about it. What do you think is going to be at the Nintendo Direct? I know this video is a little bit light on information, a little bit impromptu, but I had no plan on doing this, so this is really coming off the top of my head. So, of course, if you want to continue getting videos from me, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell button. Follow me on Twitter, like my video, tweet, and I will shout you out. Drop a comment down below to help the channel grow, so and so I can talk to you about this Nintendo Direct, as well as check out any of the other videos that I have mentioned in this video if you want more information on the possible projects that are going to come out. And as always, people, keep it real.